Good evening, grade 12s, 2021. This is Mr. Ross from Wattenbrod Sutherland High School in Somerset West, and we are still busy with our first theme on the Cold War. Remember, you are looking at paper 1 end of the year exams, and there's three topics, and all three topics has two questions. One will be source-based and one will be an essay. So in the previous video, we looked at the source-based, the spheres of influence between the USA and the USSR. Now we're going to look at the essay question for paper 1 on the Cold War. In this extension of the Cold War will be a case study about Vietnam. Now before we can do that, I need to give you first some advice. When we start marking, we first check if you has taken a point of view. You must take a line of argument and you must stick right through your essay to the same line of argument. In this case, you're going to talk about, the question can read something like, critically discuss the changing nature of the United States' involvement in Vietnam at different stages between 1957 and 1973. A good point to start off in any essay is to use the question and make it a statement and just elaborate on it. So in an introduction for an essay, you will give me something like, the United States is in Vietnam, or the United States' involvement in Vietnam during the period 1957 to 1973 can be divided into three phases, namely an advisory phase, a containment phase, and direct involvement. In my essay, I'm going to try and explain why the focus of the United States has shifted. What did you immediately do? You told me when 1957 to 73, you told me where in Vietnam, and you told me who, the United States. So you have already put me in the picture. You have also told me what your line of argument will be. So you are going to explain, it's what you said, you're going to explain the United States involvement and how their focus have changed into three different phases. And that is what we want. We want to know immediately that you are taking a stand. So during the first phase, this will be your first paragraph. During the first phase of the United States involvement in 1957 to 65, giving you the dates, 57 to 65 will be the first stage, they supplied South Vietnam with military aid as well as sending advisors, and although limited, they increasingly sent ground troops. You get it, what? They're not getting directly involved in the Civil War. They are sending advisors, people to help the South Vietnamese soldiers to teach them about war. So they increasingly send ground troops to Vietnam. All of this happened during the Civil War. The United States tried very hard to follow a policy of containment. You can imagine, here you have this powerful superpower, the United States of America. But because they don't want to get directly involved, it was very difficult for them to have this policy of containment in the context of the Cold War. Any aggression from their side will lead to aggression from the USSR, and that's what they know. So they didn't want to get directly involved. And initially, they did not want to commit more ground troops, so they've been sending these advisors to support the South Vietnamese government, and this government followed a capitalistic policy. And that is why the United States supported them, because of capitalism. And they actually justified what they were doing by saying that they are trying to protect South Vietnam from the communist North Vietnam. And that is why they were sending advisors. From 1957, North Vietnam, seeing what the United States are doing in South Vietnam, contacted the Russians, the USSR, and the USSR, they told them, or they showed them how to use guerrilla tactics, and they sent military aid. Now we're having the Cold War all over again. United States on the one side, USSR on the other side, but no direct conflict, ideological conflict, supporting other countries with advisors and with soldiers. So from 1957, North Vietnam intensified. Now, before that, you must understand that they became very popular. North Vietnam and the communist government became popular. And the South Vietnam government under Diem were very, very worried about this. So when North Vietnam intensified their efforts to take control of South Vietnam, the USSR got directly involved, helping the North Vietnamese. South Vietnamese under them were very, very unpopular at this stage. And this created a problem for John F. Kennedy, the American president. He was supporting a man that was not supported by his own people anymore. And that was sort of a very tricky situation. And so by 1963, there were 11,000 United States troops in Vietnam. The United States supported safe villages. So what were they saying? We can't get directly involved, but we can protect certain villages and send the South Vietnamese people there so that they can feel safe. They actually forced people to go to the safe villages, and this was a point in time when the CIA got involved. In 1963, the United States, through the CIA, helped the South Vietnamese army to overthrow Diem and take the power in South Vietnam. In 1964, the first turning point in this war took place, and that was the incident at the Gulf of Tonkin. Now, what happened here? Some American ships were bombarded, and the Americans claimed that North Vietnam has attacked their ships, and they justified their position of sending more ground troops and military aid to South Vietnam. Remember that? That was a turning point. When we mark, we're looking for certain things. And one of the things we're going to look at here is your turning points. And the turning point here was the incident at the Gulf of Tonkin. But this would also lead to a second phase. The nature of involvement between 1965 and 1969, second period of involvement, was a period of intense U.S. intervention. Now, remember, we make use of the Peel system, point, explanation, evidence, and a link. So you need to give me, if you have a point in a paragraph, and you have given me some explanation of that point, and you have provided me with evidence, you need to link that paragraph to the next paragraph. Now, in the previous paragraph, we said that the United States didn't want to get directly involved. We are now in the second phase, and we immediately start with the nature of involvement change. Can you see how we've connected the two paragraphs? So from 1965 to 1969, there was a period of intense United States intervention, and this was to bomb and to send combat troops to Vietnam. So they would bomb military installations, they would bomb the soldiers and the Vietnamese army. So the United States, they committed more ground troops, and by 1967, there were 500,000 USA troops stationed in Vietnam. 500,000, guys, that is a lot. 500,000 troops were in Vietnam. And here they started certain operations because they now have power behind them, because they have numbers behind them. So what would happen now? From 1965 to 1968, they started with Operation Rolling Thunder. Now what was this? It was a military action whereby aerial bombing would take place. They would throw bombs on the North Vietnamese strong points. The United States used helicopters to do search and destroy missions. So they'd fly low over Vietnam, North Vietnamese army camps and so on, and they would destroy it by bombing these targets in North Vietnamese strongholds. It was followed up by Operation Ranch End. Now, Operation Ranch End happened with the use of chemical weapons such as napalm and then Agents Orange and Blue in an attempt to deforest the areas where the North Vietnamese soldiers were hiding out or were taking refuge. When they had no more cover, the targets were very, very clear to the American Air Force. So what would happen next? This then led to one of the most tragic events and another turning point in this whole essay, that is in this whole episode, and in the essay you must mention it. The next turning point was the 1968 massacre at My Lai. Now, what has happened at My Lai? My Lai is a place. Here, American soldiers attacked, raped, and killed women and children and put the bodies on heaps outside so that anybody can see it. They even had journalists taking photos of this. It was a terrible, terrible incident in history. It was later revealed that this led, when this was revealed eventually, it led to the growth of anti-war movements in the United States especially, and people were calling for the troops to return. Also in 1968, there were some peace talks between the USA and Vietnam, and it started in Paris. And then in 1968, another turning point was the Tet Offensive, which showed the USA public that the USA was not winning the war in Vietnam, where American soldiers was led into an ambush and thousands of American soldiers died. And so the public in America was saying, "If are we sending our young men to Vietnam to die for a war that's not even ours?" And this led to the last phase of their nature of involvement in Vietnam. Now, what was the last phase? It was a period from 1969 to 1973, a period of negotiations, a period of withdrawal, and that is why we call it the third phase or the last phase. Nixon, President Nixon, Richard Nixon, he was the successor to John F. Kennedy, and he introduced the United States policy of Vietnamization. Now, what was this? It meant that the United States has decided to no longer send more ground troops to Vietnam to fight communism. The United States gradually started to withdraw their troops, but they still continued the aerial bombing. And in 1970, Nixon actually ordered the bombing of Laos and Cambodia because they wanted to cut off supplies that were transported along the Ho Chi Minh Trail to support the North Vietnamese soldiers. This bombings happened in 1970, actually it continued until 1972, and then in 1972 the Christmas bombings took place. Why called the Christmas bombings? It happened on the 25th of December, where the United States bombarded a whole number of North Vietnamese strongholds and cities on Christmas Day. It was like the last part of a country that couldn't win a war, and they wanted to have a show of force, and they did this. But in 1973, the United States signed a peace accord with North Vietnam, and United States troops, ground troops, were all withdrawn from Vietnam. The United States involvement in the Vietnam War, this can be your summary. Yeah? The United States involvement in the Vietnam War can be divided into three phases. Largely indirect intervention via military aid and advisors, an intense intervention with combat and troops sent in, and lastly a period of negotiations and withdrawal. And this happened from 1973, where all the United States troops were withdrawn and they did not win this war or contain communism. In 1975, North Vietnam took control of South Vietnam and the United Vietnam under communist government. You have ended this essay by giving me that kind of summary as you have started it. And that is what we're looking for. A full circle where you started a certain point and you ended a certain point. Remember, you must give me the turning points. You must mention the three phases. So there's three phases. There were two huge turning points, but there were other smaller turning points. If you think that a certain event or happening is a turning point, mention it as a turning point. Okay, so when we mark, we will pick that up at the end of the year. I hope you have a better understanding of this essay. I thank you.